Hello, welcome to Chris's Quick Tips for Google Sheets. In this sheet, I've got a record of my weight since 2015. The numbers are interesting, but it would obviously be much more useful to see the numbers in a chart. In this sheet, I will show you how to create a normal line chart, and then I will also show you an extremely useful timeline chart that Google Sheet keeps hidden away at the bottom of the list of charts. With data like this, I would normally produce a line chart. Google Sheet makes this very easy. With data in columns A and B, with headers in row 1 and no other data or text in these columns, it is possible to select the entire column and then click Insert Chart. The default chart that Google Sheet produces is pretty good, but I would change it so that the vertical axis does not go down to zero. Click Customize, then vertical axis, then type 60 in the minimum. Google Sheet allows you to do a lot more customization. The majority of the customizations are obvious, so I will just run through a few of the less obvious settings. Under series, it's possible to add dots to each point on the chart, or you can then remove them totally so that there are no dots on the chart. You can also add a trend line, which clearly shows that since this data started in September 2015, my weight is steadily increasing. If we now have a look at the chart style, there are a couple of interesting options. The smooth option, as its name suggests, smooths the transitions between the points in the chart. This is most noticeable as the line approaches a peak where it rounds off the peak rather than just goes to a point at the peak. The maximize option is a different layout for the chart that makes the chart as big as possible within the chart's window. I think this is a personal preference, and you may have a different preference depending on where and how you are going to use the chart. I've just created some null values in the sheet by deleting the contents of some of the cells in the data table, and the chart shows a break to indicate that there are null values for these dates. If you tick Plot Null Values, the chart will show a continuous line between the points. Let's have a quick look at data where there are two time series to plot on the same time axis. I don't run, but let's suppose I always go for a run on the same day that I weigh myself and I've recorded the distance that I've run. Create the chart the same way by selecting the three columns and clicking Insert Chart. The distance run are much lower numbers than my weight, so this chart would look better with a second vertical axis with a different scale. Select the Customize tab and the Series section. Select the Run Series and change the axis to the right axis. You can change the setup of the right axis by clicking the new section that has appeared called Right Vertical Axis. You can then change the maximum to 10. To edit the left axis, click on Vertical Axis. I think that setting the minimum to 60 gives a nice separation to the two lines so that the chart is easily readable. When you have got multiple lines on a chart, you can enable Compare Mode, which is in the Chart Style section. When you are moving the mouse over the chart, the pop-up shows you details about both the points on both lines for that date, even though the mouse is only over one of the lines. Compare this when the compare mode is not enabled, and you'll see that when you mouse over a line, you only get details about that line. It's important to note that in order to see this pop-up window, the chart editor must be closed. If chart edit is open and you move the mouse over the chart, it simply highlights the different elements of the chart. So if you are not seeing the pop-up window, close the chart editor pane. A quick way to customize a chart is to double-click the element of the chart that you want to customize. You can do this if the chart edit pane is open or not. For example, if you want to customize the right vertical axis, double click and the edit pane will open on the Customize tab with the right vertical section expanded. This works for all elements of the chart. Google Chart includes a very useful timeline chart that is hidden away at the bottom of the list of chart types. Click on the icon of the timeline chart. You can customize the chart as shown. The date range selector is at the bottom of the chart. By simply dragging the start and end markers, you can zoom in or out on specific date ranges. If you zoom in on just a few months, you will see that the date range selector also zooms in to allow you to more precisely position the start and end markers. To zoom out again, drag the left and right date markers to the far left and far right. The chart automatically abbreviates or expands the year and month names to ensure that the horizontal axis labels are readable and not squashed. If you do not want the date range selector in your chart, untick the Show Date Range Selector box in the Chart Editor pane. There are also zoom buttons at the top left of the chart with some standard time periods. The markers in the Date Range Selector show the start and end of the date period displayed on the graph. Once the required zoom level has been selected, you can then click and hold between the start and end date markers and then drag the date range left and right on the timeline. The zoom button can also be disabled in the chart editor. The timeline chart can also be annotated with up to two columns of comments. The comments are taken from the two additional columns and are placed to the right of the chart with the date for the comment. The first column's comment, which in this case is the minimum and maximum, are in bold text. All points on the chart with a comment in either column C or D are marked on the chart with a letter so that you can easily see the relevant comment for the relevant date. You can also click on the letter on the chart, which will shade the relevant comment. Or alternatively, you can click on the comment. The letter on the chart is changed to bold font when you click it. Unfortunately, this change is actually too subtle to really highlight the letter on the chart. This timeline chart is very useful and very flexible. It's a pity that it's not a suggested chart and that you have to scroll right down to the bottom of the charts to find it.